Thank you for boxing. Be in the house with Theophile Pain Lopez. I'm calling you Pain for today on, man.
Okay.
You bring that pain to the table. Now, Theo, a question like this, man. Drop the knowledge. What got you into the world of boxing? How old were you when you started?
I started when I was the age of six. Like, I really started taking it serious and everything at the age of six. What started me into boxing was basically my father. He didn't bring me to the gym, to the boxing gym for himself. He brought me just there for himself. You know, it's crazy. And my dad was training for himself and everything like that, but he'll bring me along. And then just one day, when we first moved to Florida and everything, we went to this boxing gym that we had lived right by. It was called David Powell. And my father was a limousine driver, so he went to the limousine. He told the coach when he was talking to him, "Hey, I'm gonna park the limousine real quick and you watch my son until I get back." And the coach was like, "Okay, cool, yeah, I will. And then we'll talk about what we're gonna do next for himself, not for me." And the coach was like, "Hey, kid, put on some gloves." So me, 6 years old, I was like, "Yeah, okay." And then he grabbed the mitts. And by the time my dad came back, I had learned about 2-3 combinations like that. Just like that. And my father was like, "I'm 30-something. I was like, "Yeah." He's like, "I'm not going to take this serious. I'm going to invest my time in my son." And that's what he did.
At the age of six, man, you put on the gloves, you come in, you start swinging.
My first time was when I was two.
Damn.
Uh-huh.
Your amateur record. What was your amateur record?
150 with 20 losses. 150 with 20 losses.
You're a man from Brooklyn. Right. From Brooklyn.
Yeah.
You've been around.
So I know how defeat tastes.
Florida, Vegas, and now you're back in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Now, out here in Brooklyn, though, I mean, it's your hometown. How are you feeling this week?
Feels great, man, knowing that I can actually stay out here afterwards. You know, I don't have to go back to Vegas and travel 5.5 hours back. You know, I can actually just be here, chill and mellow. And on top of that, man, it's just finding out, you know, just feeling the culture and everything about it. You know, so it's great, man, fighting back here at Madison Square Garden, the Mecca of boxing. Every time I go out here and fight, man, I put on a show. It's a different energy.
This Saturday night, you on one of the biggest cards right here, Crawford versus Khan.
Yeah.
Your opponent, what do you know about your opponent?
My opponent, he's a 2-time European champion. He's a former world title challenger. He's been in the ring with plenty of guys that have a lot of experience, just as much as him. He's 31-2. His two losses have been by split decision or majority decision. So I know this guy is gonna come and try to bring the fight. That's all I really know. My father, on the other hand, he studies this guy and he told me what I have to do. And we're just gonna pick him apart come Saturday night.
At the media workout, you said it straight up, man. You coming in the house and F this cat up, man. You said it yourself, man. You wanna come in there and knock him out?
No, yeah, man. I got a lot of anger in me, man. So I gotta take it out on Saturday.
Why? Where's this anger coming from?
Huh?
Why are you angry?
Oh shit, what's up, man?
What's up, baby?
why am I angry? Cause I am, man. I just got, you know, a lot of stress that I need to relieve. So how I do it, I take it out in the ring.
Is it pertaining to the Lomachenko talk?
No. I don't. It's nothing about it. It's just family-wise. Mm. Just, yeah, more money, more problems. So I can take it out in the ring. It feels better.
Now, you said about Lomo. Mm-hmm. That's someone that you would love to get in the ring with. But you said it yourself. I mean, your dad said it. That, you know, they ducking you, man, for some reason, you know. How's your opinion on that?
Yeah, man. You know, he has his way of doing things and his way. I mean, people want to see fights like that. And I'm trying to make fights like that happen, but I can only do so much. So, you know, I went out of my way to go and do that. And now I'm done. I did what I had to do. And all it is now is just with timing. And to be honest with just winning the world title and focus on this fight, April 20th, that's the first step to everything.
In God's hands. That's it.
Yes.
That's
amen.
It. Always.
Mm-hmm.
What's up, my man?
You continue to improve, and you know, unfortunately, it seemed like, you know, the fight at your weight class may be stalled a bit. You know, you plan on moving up next year.
Yeah.
Do you think you're gonna get at least 2 championship bouts, or you're gonna be able to pick up maybe the Richard Comey fight now that he's clear?
I think the first one will be the WBC belt. Okay. Yes, with Mauricio and everything we've talked about. So I think that'll be the first one. Hopefully, we make it in July. That'll be a great one.
Back here in New York?
Probably Madison Square Garden.
Main event?
Main event.
At the theater?
Either at the theater, I even feel like we could sell it at the Garden, at the big one. But
basically, if,
you know,
if the word isn't out, you know, Garcia's gonna vacate or he's gonna defend that title.
What'd I say?
It opened. We'll make
an
announcement later.
Okay.
I'll make an announcement later. Yeah,
Teofimo, we saw Vasyl Lomachenko say that you don't have, you know, you haven't fought anybody in the top five and things of that nature. Why do everybody keep bringing you up? And we see that he had his first shot at the title and only his third fight. Do you feel like that's hypocritical?
Not even his second fight. He had his world title and stuff like that. I think that when they become, like, when you're a two-time world champion and everything, they press that more. And they're like, okay, okay, since you won two Olympic gold medals and everything, all right, here, this is what we're going to do. We're going to make you fight for the world title right away. The whole thing, man, I look at it like AIBA. It's an organization that favoritizes. It's all favoritism. You know, they have their people that they pick. So, they, unfortunately, that's how they're going to do things. They're going to make you seem this great and everything. Don't get me wrong. You still got to do a little bit of what you got to do. But when you have that type of push with you, it's a lot easier. I wouldn't say hypocritical. He did what he had to do. You know, we can't take anything away from what Lomachenko has done.
I'm not going to say hypocritical. I mean,
for him to say that, you know, he couldn't have got his shot unless Salido had gave him the shot.
Right.
Obviously, you know, and he lost. But when it's Teofimo Lopez, I think he's just aggravated about the fact that who is this kid and why are they talking so much? They should be talking about me. Lomachenko's a diva. That's why I look at him. He's like, he's a diva. He's a bitch. So then he's very delicate about his things. When he gets hit in the face and he gets bruises, he gets upset, very, very angry and everything. So you take those little things and you use them against him.
Now see your last five opponents compared to, you know, some of the other guy up and coming guys and things of that nature, even Gervonta Tank Davis. Your combined record is 135-9. Your last five opponents. Tank Davis' last combined is 129-6. So it's not that far off. You fought just as good as talent as there is.
And he's
so
world champion, though.
Right. Mm-hmm. So do you think that you're overlooked in that nature, or people are?
I'm always going to be overlooked, and that's the thing that I usually that's the thing I use against everybody.
Why?
That I'm always like underrated or whatever it is. They never want to give me my credit. I don't think anybody ever does. So I use that as just to keep me level-headed and just keep me focused. Why? I don't know. I guess I'm just that one of those guys that they just can't believe it. Some people are thinking like, with just my power and everything, they're saying that I'm on PEDs and shit like that.
You know, it's crazy. You think it's because you're outspoken?
Yeah, I'm very outspoken, but I think it's just because I'm that good.
Thanks, you know? Thank
you so much. Oh, thank you,
guys. One second, just one last question. Now, people like Lomachenko and Gervonta, have you ever been in a camp and sparred with them?
We tried to spar with Lomachenko twice, and they said no. Tank, we sparred when I was 15. He was 18. This is when I think he was like on his 6th, 7th pro fight.
Couple last words for your fans worldwide.
All right, to everybody, tune in April 20th, Teofimo Lopez, back in Mecca Boxing, Madison Square Garden, ESPN pay-per-view if you cannot make it. So tune in. And co-main event. Next fight will be main event. Teofimo Lopez signing out.
Hey,
Teofimo,
next time. 100%.